Thai. I understand from a brief conversation that this is your first visit to a Thai gathering.
Yes.
What are your sentiments? So why did you join Thai?
Well, I had heard about Thai a lot, and my husband got recruited as one of the charter members, but I wanted to become a member on my own. I've been working for the last 28, 30 years. I just recently stopped working, and we just moved to Atlanta as well. So I thought this would be a good way to get back into the business community and network with them. But this is my first attendance in Thai Atlanta, so I don't know what to expect. But I have a lot of expectations about hearing some good stuff and meeting good people, new people.
Well, welcome to Atlanta.
Thank you.
Specifically, how did you choose tonight's gathering versus the event past and the event coming up? What motivated you to attend tonight?
Because this is the first gathering after I joined Thai.
Obviously.
So, yeah. So this was the previous event had already happened when I joined, and this is the first one. So this is my first event. I'm
awesome.
Attending.
Welcome.
Thank you.
We're looking forward to a great time. What did it take to set up this kind of unique setup for Thai roundtable conferences?
So, you know, we started it last year. We just wanted to do something different. And last year we did wine and chocolate.
But this year, women's touch.
But this year, I think we just focused more on the topics and the charter members. And don't you think one of the main ideas is to expose charter members to the general membership more one-on-one?
More one-on-one, give that whole give back and their experience, knowledge, able to share it more in a setting where they can talk to each other rather than the networking environment, and have some dialogue, real dialogue. And this time we even changed it so we had more time based on some input from last year. So we're trying to improve it year after year. It was a success.
Interestingly enough, I saw the list of the topics, and it was more geared towards business versus a typical traditional women's conference.
Yeah, the topics and input. None of the topics really have a men or a women's flavor to it.
True.
The topics are generic to the workforce.
True.
Just out there being an entrepreneur, the return on Thai, branding yourself. Women and men both have the same kinds of issues. At the end of the day, they're all the same issues.
True.
You know, my goal is to get rid of the women's committee. We need
That's
to
right.
go mainstream.
We're a part of the same big committee. That's right.
So separating us doesn't... It's just that we work harder than everyone else. Besides that difference, we're exactly the same.
Any curious feedback, any specific feedback you got from people knowing that y'all are organizing this, people writing to you? Anything queer that you remember?
Well, last year, the men thought they weren't invited. They thought it looked like a women's event, like a girls' night out. So that's why we avoided
that. And this year... Because it is a members-only event, nearly 40 people signed up for Thai as members this year.
Wow.
Yeah.
That's
that's a pretty close to 40 is what I'm hearing the number.
Cool.
So yeah, I think that that we did attract a lot of new members because it's a members-only event. So that has a lot to do with it. And I think that last year, members' comments back were very unique. And I don't know if the chocolate and the wine was the unique part of it, but I think mostly the topics and being able to have some one-on-one time with the mentors.
Okay.
And the uniqueness of the topics. I think the topics, right now I'm finding out that I can only host 12 people per table, but I've got nearly 17 people on some of the tables.
Wow.
So they're overflowing right now because of the overwhelming response we've gotten back.
Well, good luck. All the best. The success is very evident. Thank you.
Thanks, Ryan.
So, hi, Christina. I just briefly spoke with you, and you said this is your first desire to attend Thai, and you're looking to be a member?
Yes.
What motivates you?
Well, my friend Subba is the one who actually told me about Thai, so I'm an invite from her. It's a group of entrepreneurs, and I'm also an entrepreneur. I'm interested in meeting like-minded people and being a part of an organization that's passionate about that.
What business are you in?
It's actually the internet website business. I work for two companies, my own and another one that actually pays the bills. Yeah. So.
And what specifically are you looking to get out of tonight?
I just want to listen. I just want to, you know, learn from other people's experience.
Well, thank you and welcome.
Okay, thank you.
Hey, Yogesh, good evening.
Good evening.
You're a Thai member. What gets you in tonight?
Yeah, tonight's discussion was, what attracted me was it was a members-only event, and it was the format was a roundtable format, which really got in my interest, peaked in the sense of really having some valid and closer discussions on certain topics, and that's what brought me here tonight.
Any particular reference or any particular interest because it's a women's committee organization tonight?
Not necessarily, but I think either they picked the topics, which were very interesting, but I feel that it was a difficult decision to pick which topic should I go in for. I wanted to attend them all, but I think the three for tonight are going to be the ones I'll focus on.
Awesome. Okay. Thank you. Thank you for your comments.
Thank you.
Welcome to one of the most powerful events that we put on at TAI as the Women's Committee team. Tonight we have with us a very special sponsor for this evening's event, and that is from Home Depot. We have a large Home Depot team members here, and with us a special member is Arlette Guthrie, the Vice President of Transformation and Diversity. So I'd like to invite her to say a few words to us, please, at this time.
On behalf of our Chairman and CEO, Frank Blake, and the Home Depot family, it is my pleasure to welcome you this evening. In fact, where are the Home Depot associates? Yes. And so, because of the entrepreneurial spirit of our founders, Bernie Marcus and Arthur Blank, just 30 years ago, when they opened the first store on Memorial Drive here in Atlanta, today we've grown to more than 2,000 stores in the United States, Canada, Mexico, and China, with 300,000 associates who continue to find entrepreneurial ways to serve the more than 1.2 billion customers we have each year.